Hey everyone, welcome to part one of the Color Sensor Shootout. In this video, I'm going to be covering the TCS 3200. It's also known as the TCS 230. This is the module here. You might have seen these before in some other videos, or even maybe have one from China. They're pretty straightforward. They're only worth a few dollars each. You can get them on eBay, and it's basically a chip inside there, which is the sensor, and then four white LEDs that are on the outside, and a whole bunch of resistors just to drive those. And it uses its own communication system and library, which you can get just as part of the normal Arduino libraries. I think it's called MD_TCS230. I'm running this particular test on a Arduino Nano compatible, a 16 megahertz board. And I've got a color OLED display here as well that's running through SPI. So before I get started, I wanted to explain why I'm looking at color sensors and what my particular purpose for testing these out are, because they're maybe not the same as some of the other channels that have looked at this particular model and dismissed it as being rubbish. And I'm not saying it's fantastic, but it really depends on what you want it for. So Jonathan Oxer from Superhouse TV, the YouTube channel, posted a video back in, it might have been 2016, that was covering the Monash Society of Electrical Engineering Robot Building Challenge. And I found the video fascinating. I'll actually put a link to the video in the description below. So basically, a group of students at Monash were given a two-day challenge to build a robot that can do line tracking, that can get from point A to point B following a line, but also when it reaches particular gates, it would stop at the gate, so it would do obstacle detection, and then it would determine what color the gate was. And then it would use, I think, IR to communicate to a control box to say, please open this color gate. And it had to open the gates in a particular sequence to be able to get through them and not smash into them. So it had to get close enough to the gate to determine that there was a gate, stop, and then what color the gate was. And they were just literally colored cards, like a red card and a blue card, a green card. And I found that part fascinating because, you know, the whole idea of how to, you know, build an AI-controlled car with line tracking, well, that's been done before. It's fairly straightforward. There are line tracking sensor modules and stuff you can get for Arduino out there with pretty thorough libraries. But I hadn't ever considered the color detection before, and I wasn't quite sure how that would work. So I started doing some research and then found these. So we're going to have a look at today, not so much how this works from a code point of view, but on how it works in determining whether a color is red, green, or blue, rather than being very specific as to what color it is, because I'm not sure that these are good enough to do that. So what I'm going to do is plug it in. And the first thing you need to do, and I've noticed on some other videos that they didn't do a calibration pass. And it's really important with these sensors to actually do a calibration pass. So as soon as I plug it in and turn it on, sorry, they're super bright. First thing it's trying to do is a black calibration, and then it tries to do a white calibration. Now, don't be fooled. It might look like there's a lot of light in the environment I'm working right now, but it's actually really, really dark. It's just the camera picks up a lot of light. So because it's so dark, it actually does a black calibration by itself, and I didn't have to stick anything black in front of it. But it's now asking for a white calibration. So I'm going to grab just some white 3D print PLA of just some scrap that I've got lying around, and I'm going to put the white near it. And as you see, as I bring it near, it's going to detect that it's white. If I pull it away, it's going to now start displaying an RGB color up top. As you can see, right now it's RGB 000, which is interesting because it's actually picking up black because of the low light. And then as I move different colors closer to it, it's going to show me on the screen in a big swatch what it thinks the color is. And then it's going to try to determine if it's red, green, or blue based on which is the highest RGB value. Now, I haven't got any thresholds in there. I haven't got any rounding or anything. It's basically going to say, well, if it's 010, then it's going to be green, even though the value is 1 and it's pretty much black. Let's actually try that out. So I've got this bit of green PLA right here. I'm just going to bring that in. And as I bring it closer, you can see already the green value is the highest. It's picking it that it's green. Right now, the green that you can see on the screen with the big swatch is about 50% brighter in the camera view than actually what it is in real life. Right now, it's a very dark, deep olive. As I bring it closer, it will actually lighten up a little bit. But either way, no matter what it's actually reproducing as a color, it's still determining correctly that it is green. So the sensor is actually working in this case. Okay, let's get a different color and grab some blue. See, right now you see that? It's got 100, so it's determining that it's seeing red. because I've got no thresholds in there. I'm going to grab some blue. Straight away, even though it's pretty far away, it can't actually show what the colour is because it can't really detect it yet. But it's detecting enough bounce that it's picking red. Blue as the dominant colour. And as I bring it in, the big colour swatch is getting a little bit more accurate. Again, it's super blown out on the camera. Both swatches are actually quite deeper in terms of blue colour. But either way, it's definitely correctly determining that that's blue. So that's working. Let's grab some red. I'm just using my awesome cutters because I don't have any red perlite sitting around. But it is, again, clearly detecting that that is red, even though the colour that it's trying to show is way out in terms of the representation of what it's actually seeing. So as a colour sensor to determine red, green and blue, it's working. So what's the fundamental problem with this sensor then? Why are people trashing it? So let's talk about how it works. What it's doing is it's obviously got some pretty bright white LEDs on there, and in real life they're nowhere near as bright as what you're seeing in camera right now, but they're still very bright. So it's bouncing white light off the item that it's looking at, and the color that's coming back is coming into the sensor, and that's how it's determining what the color is, which is fine. That's kind of working. The flaw with this is that almost all surfaces that you can do this to are quite reflective. It's very hard to get, like even for black, you know, even like a really matte painted black wood, if you put white light near it, it's going to bounce white light back as well. So even as I bring this black in, the closer I get these lights to it, it's actually changing, fundamentally changing the color of the black. It's no longer a deep black anymore. Same with blue. As I bring closer to the blue, what it's doing is turning it to a light blue. So although the blue is bouncing back correctly and is determining it's a blue for detection, in terms of actually reproducing the color that's bouncing back, the data it's getting back isn't correct because the white lights are fundamentally changing what it's looking at. Now, I'm no expert on light, wavelengths, the physics behind it all. It's still fundamentally altering the color, and you're never going to get a perfect representation. That's my opinion. Please feel free to comment below and correct me if you think that my theory is wrong. But all of the evidence I've got for every single type of item that I'm bouncing, so if I take my coffee cup, right, which is not a shiny plastic material, it's paper, and I stick the white next to it, again, it's turning it into a different color. Like, it's detecting it's red, but it's not detecting what the color is very well. So, is this a good sensor? Well, it definitely works to do what I needed to do, which is to determine if something is red, green, or blue. It's not fantastic from a distance. As you can see, about 10 centimeters is probably the starting point for determining a color change. Maybe a little bit more, maybe 12 centimeters. But it needs to actually be sitting at about 1 centimeter or 10 millimeters away to get a good representation of what the actual color is. So not to determine if it's green, but to actually try to show the correct color, like to capture the proper RGB color of what it thinks it is. It's somewhere between 10 millimeters and maybe 5 millimeters. Get too close and it just turns white. So does the sensor work? Yes, it does. Is it accurate enough for my needs? Absolutely. Considering that it's, again, I think I bought 3 for $7 or something like that. It's definitely a cheap enough sensor and it'll definitely do the job. But can we do better in terms of actual color detection? Well, we'll find that out in the next video. If you want to have a look at my code, please put a comment below. If I get enough people commenting, I'm happy to go through my code that shows how all this works. But these videos are not really about how to code up a color sensor. They're really about how good are they in my use case, which is to detect red, green, or blue gates. If enough people comment, I might do a follow-up video that covers the code. Otherwise, the next video will be looking at one of the Adafruit color sensors, and we'll see if it's any better at detection and determining what the actual color is. Thanks for watching. Thumbs up if you think it's worth it. Thumbs down if you, again, didn't like it. Share. Don't forget to subscribe. Catch you next time. Bye.